So this morning, I had an awesome breakfast. What did you have for breakfast?
I had a whole 5 bananas.
That's all?
Yeah. 5 bananas, 5 almonds, of course.
Just looked around and got creative. I put in a banana, a mango, and one date. And it looks so pretty. And it tasted 10 times better. So it was a really great breakfast.
That's bonus.
I mean, with mango, how can I go wrong? I love mangoes.
Tricycle in my kitchen. You're ready to go, aren't you?
Yes.
I have my breakfast here, which I may have to add to it because this is just not enough goodness. It's so delicious. Banana, mango, and dates.
And it gave me so much energy that morning too. I was chasing the kids all around the park over and over because it's kind of like running down towards the road, and it was a long ways towards the road. He thought he was really hilarious, so he'd run giggling and I'd chase after him. And I did it over and over again, and you know how I hate running.
Mm-hmm.
Don't have a lung capacity for it usually. I wasn't tired at all.
Okay.
I'm gonna get you. Guess what? Mama can run now. Run without getting tired for quite some time. What's this? The 7th time you've made me do this? No, no. You're so funny. I love you. Whee! Up we go. Up we go. Oh no, I trapped you.
Granted, I didn't eat any more for breakfast because I ran 2 miles.
I should have made you some beet juice.
And got in 10,000 steps afterwards.
Wow. That's awesome. How did the rest of your day go?
So today, my coworkers who've been watching me go through this whole process for the last month, and from their point of view, somewhat horrified by some of the things I've been bringing in for food. They decided to take me out, well, a couple of them anyway, took me out and we went and got Indian food. So, gave me diet, got murdered.
Hope you took it easy.
I did, actually. I did.
There's a dog that just joined us.
Sidekick down here.
Evie. What did you tell me the other day somebody said to you about eating no meats or animal products? What did somebody say to you? Tell me that story again.
Oh, one of my coworkers, he's usually pretty opinionated about just about everything. I came into the shop and a different coworker asked me how I was doing on the diet. Was it almost over? Or she knew the end date was coming up pretty close. And he's like, oh, what's going on? What have you been eating? I told him, you know, we're doing a raw vegan diet and everything. And had to explain a little bit about what that actually meant. And then he was like, oh my word, that's just crazy. There's no way you can survive. There's no way you could do that. You die without eating enough protein. And I'm like, really? I don't feel dead. You haven't been doing this very long. I'm like, I've done it for a whole month, so I'm still going strong. Mm-hmm. He didn't know what to say after that, pretty much. Other than, well, no, he did come back with, oh, you can't do it for very long. Much longer than a month. And I told him there's plenty of videos of people out there that have been doing it for a decade or 2 decades or whatever. And they're probably in better shape than he is.
Why, like some of those Olympians. Man, they've got some muscles and some stamina that we could just dream about. But I saw a really great video recently of a gentleman who does high-energy parenting, and he ran a marathon, and he was talking about his time and how much he did, and remember, you even were like, wow, he runs that much.
Mm-hmm.
And he said it was no big deal and he wasn't that impressed with his numbers. Yes, he won, and yes, his numbers seem very high. He goes, we think of all the Olympic athletes out there as this really high, almost unattainable level of fitness. But if everybody was eating right and if everybody was exercising every day, as they do in some cultures, everybody eats the same thing, they do the same amount of exercise, they have to run and move and explore and do whatever it takes to live the lifestyle that they live out there, they're all Olympic athletes and it's no big deal to them. Mm-hmm. Everyone's that way.
That's the norm for them.
Well, just feeling that little extra bit of energy this morning that I normally didn't have tells me that I'm on the right path. And I've got a lot of other health issues that I would like to backspace across and get rid of and not have to deal with that for the rest of my life. That would be wonderful. So many other people in my family, thankfully, if you know your family and your family's history coming from all these different generations, what's on your mother's side, what's on your father's side, you know what struggles they have or the ones that have passed on have had, and you can target those things in your mind first and then start going after them. But I think one thing at a time is probably good, because if we try to solve all the world's problems for ourselves immediately, we're going to solve nothing. Mm-hmm. It takes time to form a habit, and once we get a habit formed, it'll be easy to do that and then tackle the next thing. Mm-hmm. We'll end up appearing as if we're very disciplined when we just took the time it took to create one habit at a time. So, how do you feel going from here? What are your goals?
I think going from here, I'd like to try and stay with this. I'm not totally sold on the vegan-only thing yet, honestly. Maybe just partially live up to this point. I've never done much vitamins, vegan lifestyle-wise. But I would like to at least try, you know, first half of the day at least, so to speak, going with the vegan front. We haven't been doing milk in the house for 6-9 months anyway, so that's not like a real big change for breakfast or anything. To just do smoothie or something like that. And then lunch is relatively simple. I don't know if you will supplement that at all. If I'm still hungry, kind of see how that goes. And then, you know, a nice full hot dinner. I don't like cold dinners, sorry.
This is a lot more work on my part, because all you have to do is sit down and eat it. I'm the one who has to get new cookbooks, new recipes, go to the store most of the time, though you help me out with that a lot and do the meal prep. So I'm going to be working hard to make this work, but I believe it's worth it. And I also really like the idea of honesty and more honesty with our children. Especially with picky eaters, to just put something in front of them and expect them to eat it, and this is good for you, so eat it, isn't how I want to approach things. So you're going to sit there and you're going to eat that. Instead of making it fun, and instead of explaining why we choose to eat these things and all these wonderful things that will happen inside your body and help you grow because of it, and why we choose not to eat other things because of all the detriment that can happen to your body, especially the longer and longer you live on that lifestyle, the disease that can creep in. And knowing that ahead of time, and knowing that they feel good in themselves will help.
We decided to make Christina's carrot cake recipe, and I'll put the link for that below. It turned out amazing. And I just really loved having the kids help me do this. This was our celebration dessert for finishing strong this month, and they got to participate in that, especially draining out the and coconuts. That was a lot of fun for our eldest, and the little one's job was mostly taste tester, and he enjoyed that important role as well.
types of foods, and eventually they're going to be buying and prepping their own food. And what did you know how to make when we were just married?
Omelets, beef stroganoff, breakfast cereal, it's a big one. What else can I make when we were first married?
Make mac and cheese out of a box.
Yeah, pretty much. Came out of a box. I was relatively safe on that one, but it's also about what I can still make. But cooking, not my favorite thing by any means. So, yeah, we really expanded that. Celery with peanut butter was a favorite there. That's about it. I really don't like cooking. I really don't. Sorry, I know that's actually a word menu, but I really hate to cook.
Well, now, especially if we're working on a lot of raw meals, it's not so much about cooking, it's just about fun combination of flavors and textures, knowing which ones go together really well. Everything goes well with greens. Things that don't go well together would be like an orange and a banana. You've got an acid fruit and a more fatty fruit. If you mix them together in a smoothie, they would separate, and it would do that in your stomach too, not be pleasant. So, knowing which ones blend together well. Mm-hmm. Berries and bananas.
Which ones don't, like avocado.
Though you like that salad dressing that I made with avocado.
Yeah, there's enough stuff in there to blend it, I can taste it, apparently. But the only thing I haven't tasted in when you're stuck in something.
I just have to get more creative.
Yeah, because I know I surprised you the other night when I sat down to eat something and like, oh, the first thing I smelled was avocado, and you're like, what?
How seriously? Can you smell that?
I'm like, it's really strong. It's avocado.
Well, it smells onion. How can you smell anything over onion? He apparently can.
One thing that I'm kind of interested to see is, realistically, I guess ever since we started this little journey with the Navy and everything, we've been really trying to follow the concept of God's in control. And he's led us down this path, and I know you feel super strongly about this. Like I said, I'm still working on the super strongly part, but if it's the door that God's going to open for us, it's going to be really interesting to see where that goes from here. We're going to rely on him to take care of us and take care of this new direction that we're going, realistically. It's going to be interesting to see how that plays out. So, we've talked before about whether this is going to be more expensive by a little bit or a lot or not or what. And, if it is going to be more expensive, then seeing how God's going to help provide for doing this and making this work for us and helping us decide, or working together, I guess, more with what we like, what we don't like to eat. Probably problematic on the law kind of thing.
One but, thing.
Yeah. See, only have one problem with me. Not easy. It should be really interesting to see what direction God takes us and how he blesses us with health and opportunities we have to share with other people and help people out, or who knows, all the possibilities.
I know that throughout the years that we have been married, anytime anything has come up where we've been asked to be good stewards, and we've promised to be good stewards with what God has given us, and specifically I'll focus on our pets. There have been many times when a health crisis would come up with one of our pets, and even though I was a vet tech and had access to a lot of resources and discounts, there were some pretty heavy hits that we had. Broken leg, epilepsy, things like that, where we didn't know what was going to be down the road, but all you can see at first is this huge dollar sign. Mm-hmm. And you look at your bank account, and the amount you have to spend is this, and how much you have to spend is this. And going to God and saying, I promise to be a good steward of this life that you put in my care. This is your creation. You've asked me to care for it, and I'm going to trust you to supply the resources because you're the provider. God is our provider, and he's never not come through for us in amazing ways. Just through gifts, through, I don't know. Nothing short of a miracle, right?
Very much, yeah. Very much.
And I see this journey becoming vegan at our new definition of what vegan is for us, mm-hmm. as being good stewards of our bodies, mm-hmm. good stewards of the resources around us, good stewards of God's planet and the life that he's put on it, which is precious. Mm-hmm. He cares about it so much more than we could ever.
Well, that sounds like a really good, I'm glad that we're pretty well in agreement on the topic. I'm looking forward to praying with you about it and just really seeing where God takes us from here. Okay.
And I have to say to you and to everybody out there, I am so blessed. Oh my goodness, how many other husbands would voluntarily say that they were going to support me in doing a raw vegan challenge? Just out of the blue, he said that he would be supportive of this and do it with me. And I'm sure that there were lots of temptations and people saying funny things to you outside of the home.
One or two.
And he stuck with it. I've always said a man is only as good as his word. That's what I grew up hearing from great men in my family. And my husband has definitely been a man of his word through this. And of his own free will.
Sort of. Lots of arm twisting going on.
Kind of Yeah,
see?
Well, I mean, I'm just blown away. I am so grateful. And I love you so much. And I realize that there aren't many men out there that would do something like this. So, I love you.
I love you too.
Not that you can tell a difference at all, but I did take before and after pictures. I asked Brian and he said he had lost a total of 9 pounds. We don't own a scale, so I had to go to my chiropractor's office to find out that I lost about 3 pounds. Not that much, but I have changed pant sizes again, and that's always pretty neat. And again, it wasn't about losing weight for us, it was about getting healthy, and the journey along the way has been amazing. We've learned a lot more and gained a lot more benefit.
Where's our cake? Where's our cake?
Just a minute, Amber.